Today we're going to talk about the Cavite Mutiny of 1872 and the death of Gomburza. The Cavite Mutiny of 1872 and the death of Gomburza are directly related to one another because the Cavite Mutiny of 1872 would be used to accuse the Gomburza so that they would be killed, so that they could, so that Spanish officials could get rid of each one of them. Now we discuss these two important events in Philippine history during the Spanish occupation of the Philippines. Okay, backgrounder first. Prior to the coming of General Rafael Izquierdo, there is this Carlos Maria de la Torre. Carlos Maria de la Torre is the Governor General or the General who is leading the Philippines prior to the coming of Rafael Izquierdo. And the style of leadership of Carlos Maria de la Torre is democratic. What do we mean when we say democratic? Carlos Maria de la Torre is respected by the Filipino people then because he would usually take time to listen to them. He introduced reforms. When I say he introduced reforms, unlike his predecessors, Carlos Maria de la Torre would usually come out and be with people, which is something new because here comes a leader who comes directly to the people. And he also promised that he would be giving reforms to the Filipino people. He promised that he would be giving Filipino people their freedom. But then, because of his way of leadership, which is something new, Carlos Maria de la Torre is well-loved by the Filipino people. Then, some Spanish officials were alerted by his kind of leadership. And they were afraid that because of Carlos Maria de la Torre's way of leadership, Carlos Maria de la Torre's mind is being towards the people. And the Spanish people, the Spanish authority, hates that idea of a leader being closed to the Filipino people, being loved by the Filipino people. Because for them, a governor general, a leader like Carlos Maria de la Torre, should be for the Spanish crown, should be with the Spanish authority, not with the Filipino people. What happened because of his kind of leadership, he was then succeeded by Rafael Izquierdo. General Rafael Izquierdo is the governor general. Okay? General Rafael Izquierdo is the governor general who succeeded Carlos Maria de la Torre. During the time of Carlos Maria de la Torre, those who are working are exempted from forced labor. Okay? He introduced some reforms like equality. When I say equality, he has this idea that when you work, you will no longer be paying tax. When you work within the government, when you work as a soldier, you will no longer be asked to render forced labor. And this was loved by the Filipino people. This idea was loved by the Filipino people because they will no longer be working twice as a soldier than as a person working in forced labor. But General Rafael Izquierdo has another idea. When he was assigned as the Governor General of the Philippines, one of the reforms or the changes that he made is this. Filipino soldiers working in Cavite then are also required to do forced labor. They are also required to pay taxes. And because they are required to pay taxes and they are required to do forced labor, some men decided to start an uprising because they do not want the idea of we working as soldiers, we working protecting the people as soldiers, then we'll also be asked to do forced labor. And because of this, some men, around 200 soldiers, decided to do something so that they'll be heard. Okay? This is what happened. On the night of January 20, 1872, a mutiny broke out among Filipino soldiers in the arsenal of Cavite under the leadership of Sergeant La Madrid. This mutiny was brought about by Izquierdo's abolition of their exemption from tributes and forced labor which the soldiers previously enjoyed. Okay? The idea of De La Torre's government was that when you are a soldier, you're no longer required to do forced labor and pay tributes. But during the time of Izquierdo, he decided to bring it back. No, even if they are soldiers, they're required to do forced labor, they're required to pay tributes, they're required to pay taxes. This idea was not liked by the Filipino people, so what they did was they decided to fight. They decided that they needed to be heard. Okay, on the night of January 20, 1872, a mutiny broke. What do we mean? Around 200 soldiers decided to go in a place where gunpowders, ammunitions are located. And they decided to fight back. They decided to start an uprising because they don't want an idea that they are soldiers, then they'll be asked to do forced labor. Okay? What they did was that they raided Fort San Felipe. Fort San Felipe was located in Cavite. This is where the arsenal were located. Then they decided to get the guns, gunpowder, and other kinds of ammunition that they could use to fight back. Okay? So we go back. Cavite Mutiny of 1872. Was the Cavite Mutiny successful? No. Okay? Some people died and eventually some people were arrested. So that is the Cavite Mutiny of 1872 because they were being forced to work again. They decided to stand up and say, no, we're going to stand up for our rights. We're not going to go back to forced labor. Okay? The Cavite Mutiny of 1872 was not successful. Okay? Was not successful. Now, the question is, what is the relationship between the Cavite Mutiny of 1872 and the death of Gomburza? This is what happened. The Gomburza, as we all know, were the three priests who were asking for reforms. What they want is that we as priests should be allowed to manage parishes. Okay? There should be parishes, there should be places, there should be convents headed by the Filipino friars. There should be equal treatment. They should not just be handled by the Spanish priests. Filipino priests should be allowed to administer the sacraments. Filipino priests should be allowed to lead a congregation because for them, as Filipinos, they know the needs of the people, but the Spanish government says no. Okay? No. Filipino priests should not be allowed to work, okay? To unite, to bring the word of God to the people. Okay? So because of that idea that they wanted reforms in how priests are treated and they are considered as threat by the Spanish government, Rafael Izquierdo decided to come up with something. This is what he did. Okay? He decided to come up with a story that the Cavite Mutiny of 1872 was started or was the brainchild of the Gomburza. They were the ones who were behind the men who raided Fort San Felipe in Cavite because they were asking for reforms. And Rafael Izquierdo decided to come up with an idea that let us blame Gomburza for the Cavite Mutiny. Let us have a trial. Okay? And through this trial, this is what we're going to do. We're going to say that Gomburza decided to convince these men in Cavite to start a mutiny against the Spanish government. Okay? So they were like the main suspects. They were like the culprits of what happened. Okay? A mock trial, okay, an investigation was conducted. So what do you expect? Okay? It was stated that the Cavite Mutiny of 1872 was started by Gomburza. Because they were not allowed to lead parishes, they started a revolt against the Spanish government. Was this successful? Yes, that is why we have what we call in Philippine history, the martyrdom of Gomburza. Okay? Mariano Gomez de Los Angeles is one of the priests. Okay, he is from Santa Cruz, Manila. He was 72 years old then. We have Jose Apolonio Burgos y Garcia. Okay, Father Burgos, who is 35 years old then. He was from Vigan, Ilocos Sur. Okay, we have Jocinto Zamora y del Rosario from Pandacan, Manila, 36 years old. Okay, Mariano Gomez, Jose Burgos, and Jocinto Zamora, who were executed by Garrote on February 17, 1872. The mutiny happened on January. And then, they were killed, they were executed through the Garrote on February 17, 1872. Okay? And in every trial, there is a witness, right? In every trial, there is a witness. Okay, there's this guy who pointed to the three priests that they were the culprit of the Cavite Mutiny. What they did was, okay, who is there anyone who could prove that these three priests were part of the Cavite Mutiny? And they use a particular guy. Okay, there is this Francisco Saldua. Francisco Saldua testified against the Gomburza. He was the principal witness who stated that Gomburza started the Cavite Mutiny of 1872. And this was honored by Rafael Izquierdo so that he could pursue with his plan of killing these three priests through Gomburza. The idea then was to scare the Filipino people, asking for reform, that whatever you do, whatever it is that you're going to start in line with you asking for freedom, would be used against you. And you will be persecuted. You will be executed. Each one of you will be penalized for whatever it is that you're going to do against the Spanish government here in the Philippines. They were killed through the Garrote. Okay, when I was younger, my idea of the Garrote was like you being hanged through a rope. But it's totally different, okay? If you see the image, if you look at the image, there's this pointed part, okay? This is being rotated, okay? This is being rotated, and this part is while this is being rotated, this part is being pushed through the spinal cord in your neck. And this pointed part of the garrote will directly hit your spinal cord, causing you to be paralyzed, causing you to immediately die. But then there are accounts that those who are being killed through the garrote, after being taken off from the garrote, they are still alive. Of course, because they are not being killed, instantly. Okay, this is a painful part of being killed. Okay, Francisco Saldua testified against the Gomburza, stating that these three priests started the Cavite Mutiny of 1872, and because they are the ones who started it, the Rafael Izquierdo decided that they should be executed. Another thing is so that no priest will no longer be asking for reforms. And the Spanish people in the government then were thinking that if we scare these Filipino people through these acts, they will submit to each one of us. They will follow us. Okay? Gomburza were killed publicly. They were executed publicly. And when they were executed, in a public ceremony. The idea was that Filipino people will be afraid of what happened. Filipino people will be afraid of the Spanish government. But the opposite happened. The killing of Gomburza angered the Filipino people. Why kill these priests? These people who are asking for reform, these people are asking for treatment. This act angered the Filipino people. The news spread out throughout the Philippines that Gomburza were killed. Okay. And because of this act, Filipino people became angry. They were angered by the killing of these people and they started revolts from different areas of the Philippines. And when the Gomburza, okay, when Gomburza, the Gomburza, okay, when Gomburza was executed, were executed, Paciano Rizal was present. He saw how these three priests were killed through the garrote. And he narrated this story to Jose Rizal. He narrated this story to Jose Rizal. Cavite Mutiny of 1872, some 200 men raided Fort San Felipe asking for reform, these three priests asking for equal treatment for Filipino priests. But then they were not allowed, so they were killed. And this angered the Filipino people. And this is the story of the Cavite Mutiny of 1872 and the death of Gomburza. If you have any questions or if you want to get to know something or if you want to clarify something, please feel free to comment and leave a comment so that I would be reading and replying, and do not forget to subscribe.